In this video, I'm going to show you a quick and simple way to redesign loops using a plugin called Regroover from Acusonus. We're also going to take a look at how to extract individual elements as well as remove unwanted elements from your loops and much more. Hello, music producers! What's going on? I hope you're doing great. If this is your first time here and you want to learn all about FL Studio and music production in general, then make sure to hit that subscribe button and the bell so that you don't miss anything. Today, we're going to have a look at Regroover from Acusonus. Regroover is a plugin that uses advanced algorithms to analyze loops and split them up into their individual elements. You can actually redesign entire loops from within this plugin itself. You can also extract bits and pieces from any loop and much more. It also provides seamless integration with your DAW of choice, which will speed up your workflow a lot. If you work with a lot of loops in general, then you will most likely find this tool invaluable. It has certainly become an important part of my own workflow lately. When it comes to music production, workflow is everything. From the very moment you start working on a new track, it's a race against time to get the track completed before you eventually get sick and tired of it. You want software that works with you, not against you. When I choose my plugins, I have two main criteria. They have to sound good, obviously, and they have to facilitate a fast workflow. Regroover is one such plugin that I find speeds up workflow tremendously, and it sounds good too. Let me show you some of the things this plugin can do. Let's go ahead and load it into the channel rack. The interface is quite straightforward and intuitive. Just find a loop you like and drag it in. This one sounds quite nice. Notice how it automatically split the loop into individual sections. If you want to spread it over more tracks or less, you can use this slider to increase or decrease the amount and then click the split button again. The slider here is for the sensitivity. When you drag in a loop, it automatically synchronizes it to the project tempo. If you want to adjust the project tempo later on, you can hit the sync button and it will automatically resync. Let's go ahead and remove some of the elements here. Many loops have some variation going on toward the end. You may not want that. In this case, you can just use the eraser tool, mark the stuff you don't want, and click the split button. You can also adjust the loop markers here to loop just this section of the track, for example, while the others play for the entire extent of the loop. Let's imagine a typical scenario where you have a track with some hats, shakers, rides, or whatever is already in place, and you're just looking for some percussive elements to fill out the lower mids. You find a loop with some nice mid-lows that you like, but then there's hats and other stuff going on too. In that case, you can just drag it into Regroover and mute all the tracks you don't want, or perhaps you just want the hats. Here we have a very basic trance bassline setup. There's some percussion already going on. Let's see if we can extract some nice top end from a loop and add to this. That sounds quite nice. Other times you might have a loop with a kick you really like. This tool makes it extremely easy to grab certain elements from any loop, rearrange them, or take stuff out. Now I have just the kick. There's also an effects section with gate, EQ, compression, and saturation that you can apply to the various tracks, so you can do some basic mixing with the plugin itself. You can use this fader right here to adjust the volume of the individual tracks in the loop. This is quite handy, as oftentimes some of the elements in a loop are too loud or too quiet. There's also a stereo separation, panning, and so on. It's nice to have this readily available right here in case you want to do some very quick editing. Again, workflow is key. If you want more control, you can use the multi-out option here to send the various tracks to individual mixer tracks so that you can apply your own processing there as well. Next, let's have a quick look at the expansion kit in the lower right corner. You can select any sample and just drag it in like this. Then you can use the editor to do further adjustments. Start and stop timers, envelope, and so on. You can, of course, also use the piano roll itself to experiment with the loop there, too, if you'd like. Once you're done manipulating the loop, you can either leave Regroover in place as a VST, or you can save it as a WAV file using various export options. Before we wrap this up, I would like to show you more of the really nice integration you get with this plugin. Let's say I just want to grab this snare, for example. I can then select it and simply drag it into the playlist like this, or into the channel rack. Now that's some really cool integration right there. You can of course do the same thing with individual tracks from a loop, or your entire redesigned loop once you're done. Another cool thing is that you can select the length of the loop here, and it will automatically adjust to that length when you drag it in. Perhaps I just want the hats. Let's turn off the rest and drag in just that. You can pick apart your favorite loops and redesign them, or chop them up and save individual elements from each one. There's a lot of possibilities with this plugin, and this video just scratched the surface. Now, some of you will probably argue that you can just use SliceX to achieve this. Well, SliceX is good for a lot of things, primarily chopping up bits and pieces from loops and such, and for that, it works great. But when you try to rearrange loops with it, it inevitably tends to sound a bit staccato. This plugin seems to have a more advanced algorithm, and I find that it does it just so much better and faster when it comes to loops like this, and it also sounds much cleaner too. SliceX is great for vocal chops and such, but for drum loops, I prefer to use Regroover. If you already have SliceX and want to know how to use it to make vocal chops, then you might want to check out my vocal chops tutorial. You can find the link in the description below. Hopefully you now have a good idea about what you can do with Regroover. If you want to try it yourself, then you can download the demo version from acusonus.com. I'll put the link in the description below so that you can go check it out if you like. I'd like to thank our Patreons for their ongoing support, and as always, if there's any specific tutorial you'd like us to make, or if you have a question, just let us know in the comments below. Also, make sure to check out the links below if you need feedback on your music, mixing, mastering, and so on. Thanks for watching.